everyone, you're watching Wordplay with Mnemonics Part 2. This is me, Abhijaya. You can follow me on Unacademy. This is my user link. If you like this lesson, please rate, review and recommend this lesson. And if you have any suggestions or queries or doubt that need to be answered or looked into, please leave them in the comment section. We'll start a lesson with the word altruism. The word reads altruism. Our sentence is, Bill Gates is an altruistic man who has spent millions of dollars for the welfare of the people. Okay, so even though I've given the meaning of altruism, which means being selflessly concerned about the welfare of others, we could have easily picked up the meaning of this word from the sentence itself. Bill Gates, let's underline the important points. Bill Gates, altruistic, spending millions of dollars for the welfare of the people. So who would spend millions of dollars for the welfare of the people? A very generous person who wants to contribute to the community, who wants them to have the best facilities available. That is altruism. So someone who would place the other's needs before his is the quality of being altruistic. Okay? So whenever you think of altruism, think about Bill Gates and his wife Melinda Gates, who are working effortlessly for the development of underdeveloped nations. Okay? So let's look at a tip for remembering the word altruism. The tip lies in the spelling of the word itself. Now in this word you can see U comes before I. When you place the needs of others before yourself, that quality is called being altruistic or altruism. Okay? So the next word is ubiquitous. Ubiquitous. Let's read the sentence. Everyone at the music festival felt safe because the police presence was ubiquitous. Now, when would someone feel safe? When the police is present everywhere, right? Only then you can feel safe when you see policemen are guarding the music festival or a concert that you've been to. Okay? So I've given the image over here, police being stationed at a corner. The tip to remember ubiquitous again lies in the spelling itself. So the meaning of ubiquitous is being present everywhere at once. The tip now is to divide the word into three segments. Ubi, quit and us. You can see in each segment U appears, right? So something that is present everywhere at once is ubiquitous. Now the next word is sanctimonious. Let's read the sentence. Sarah is a sanctimonious woman who looks down upon those who do not volunteer at the NGO as much as she does. Okay, so Sarah is a sanctimonious woman who looks down upon people. So who would look down upon people? When would someone look down upon someone? When someone thinks that they are better than the other, and even so morally better than the other, is when they would look down on the other, right? So sanctimonious means just that. Sanctimonious means pretending to be morally better than the others. They think they might not actually be morally better or just better at all, but they just think that they are better than their others. Okay? Now, to remember this word, we are again going to break down the word into three segments, sancti, moni and us. Now, sancti can be taken from the word sanctity, which means sacred. Moni, of course, means money, and us. So, sacred and money. Why sacred? Because you have to be morally better than the others to be sanctimonious, right? And money. So, usually people who have a lot of money, they think that other people, they don't care about other people or their needs. And that's why they think that they're better than the others just because they're rich. Which is not true, right? I've given a picture of a king. In the olden times, it was believed that that God decided who the king should be, right? So everything that the king commanded would be looked up to as God's commands, which was wrong. So because, of course, God would not ever want treachery or hardships in brought about by a king's commands, right? So, coming back to a word, sanctimonious, which means pretending to be morally better than the others. The next word is propensity. Let's look at the sentence. Arya has a propensity to clean when she gets anxious. Okay, so I've given the meaning over here. Propensity means an inclination or tendency to do something. So we all have a tendency to do something, right? When we say anxious. So a friend of mine, when she gets anxious, she starts cleaning the bathroom. I mean, what? Why the bathroom? There's plenty of things to clean, but no, she just wants to clean the bathroom. Okay? So propensity means inclination or tendency to do something. Now, how to remember this word propensity? Again, divide this word into three parts: pro, pen, and city. To remember this word, just ignore pen, okay? Now, pro. What does pro mean? In favor of. And city, we can, of course, it's close to city, right? Just this SNC. So, pro city. So, in favor of city or inclining towards city. Now, villages like India, everybody from villages are migrating towards cities in hopes of new jobs and new opportunities. It's not solving the problem, but it's just their hope. So, inclining towards cities or in favor of cities. So, propensity means a tendency or inclination towards something. Okay? Cool. The last word for this lesson. Insidious. Have you ever heard this word? In our last lesson, we spoke about horror movies and Insidious is one of them. It's pretty scary. It's a lot scarier than Mirrors. So if you haven't watched Insidious, please do. So let's read our sentence. The cult leader hatched an insidious plan to acquire his followers' assets. Okay, so what is a cult? A cult is a group of people who have common beliefs in faith or religion, or not just that, but just common beliefs about life. Okay, so the cult leader hatched an insidious plan to acquire his followers' assets. An insidious plan would be deceitful or treacherous. Okay, so let's look at the meaning of insidious. Here is a cult, a woman who is in a cult. Okay. Insidious. Meaning of insidious is deceptive or causing harm secretly. Okay. So even diseases, some diseases, they are hidden and they are causing harm secretly. So we can call them as insidious. An insidious disease. The tip that we can use to remember this word is inside plus hideous. So I spoke about diseases. Now cancer is such one disease. It's never diagnosed early. I mean, we never get to know the indications of cancer soon. And so it causes harm secretly to a body. So insidious means causing harm secretly. So I hope you like this lesson. I'll be back with more words and word wordplay with mnemonics. Bye.